Hello folks, and welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Octavio, around here they call me Oc. Today we are looking at this 282QBXL. Outside kitchen, quad bunks, front queen. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Okay guys, so let's go ahead and get some details out of the way here. So the dry weight of this particular camper is gonna be 6,149 pounds with a full GVWR of 7,636 pounds. Give me about 1,400 pounds or so of cargo carrying capacity that you can carry on this coach. All right guys, so for your gallon or your water capacity on this, you're gonna be looking at a 40 gallon fresh water tank, a 66 gallon gray water tank, and a 34 gallon black water tank. Let's go ahead and start with this tour. Okay guys, so one of the things that happened recently is we had a hailstorm. And when there is hailstorm at the Great Outdoors RV, there's hail sale. So this is gonna be one of the coaches that are on our hail sale. Make sure you check on those prices because we are marking these down considerably, guys. It's worth taking a look at. Now, this coach is gonna come in at 31 feet, 10 inches or so. With an awning that's about 3/4 of the size of the coach. You have an LED strip that runs all the full length of that awning on the bottom there, giving you that light when you're in the camping season. Exterior marine grade speakers. You have a hood vent for the stove that's inside. This is the refrigerator, the back of it for servicing purposes. Dual axle, guys, that's what gives you that cargo carrying capacity, 1,400 pounds or so, if you wanna load this up all the way. You have an outside kitchen over here. So, you know, one of the benefits of having an outside kitchen is you're gonna be spending your time outside, right? You got your awning out here, you got your outside kitchen. It does come with a grill. Now this swings back to the back of the RV to get put away or for transport reasons. Small electric refrigerator here. You do have to be hooked up to 110 power for this to work, but it's a nice little option. Sink, and this all gets put away. So you got these two latches here, and this door comes down like so. You got your double latches with the locking, which is good. So this coach does come with 4-point stabilization. You have two stabilizing jacks on the front, two on the back here. It just makes it for a more steadier coach when you have a lot of guests inside the coach and you want it not to be rocking around or anything like that. Those stabilizer jacks do their work. So coming on towards the front here, potable water fill here. This is where I fill my canteen or my fresh water tank. Nice radius door that we have here with the screen option. It's always good for the bugs, maybe get that air moving and stuff like that. Coming towards the front over here, we have some underbed storage. This is pretty nice. This is full pass-thru, goes all the way through as you can see. And you can access that from under the bed, which is a queen size. Furion solar power plug here. Now this is pre-wired for a solar panel. It's good that it's on the side. So I always like to say if you're parked in a campsite or something like that, usually under a tree or two, what happens is those systems aren't being used at their maximum capacity. So the good thing about the ones on the side is you can hook that up, bring it out here to the sun, and point it to the sun, so that way you're making sure you're getting your batteries all charged up. Now coming on towards the front over here, we have two 20-pound liquid propane bottles here with the auto changeover regulator, a power tongue jack with a little docking light in front. If you notice here, we do have the aluminum on the top here, front cap, and then you have the diamond plate down here. This is where your rocks are happening, the mud and stuff like that from the tow vehicle. So it's good that this material is present on this side. Okay guys, so this is the other side of that pass-through storage that you can see. You got your window here. This is to the bedroom. This is also an emergency window. And here you have a pretty large slide. Now this is where the couch goes, the dinette goes, and it opens it up a lot more. We'll check that out once we're inside. On the back here, you're gonna have your dump valves along with your 30 amp cord, because this does have an AC on top of it. Thing about the tanks down there is they are heated, so they have those heat pads on the tanks themselves, which is connected to a button on your control panel. You can switch those on the cold nights. It's worth doing, guys. You don't want to freeze your system. It could be bad. Okay, guys, so here we have a 6-gallon water heater. This is a gas water heater, so it creates that 6 gallons of extremely hot water. Of course, you mix that in with the cold, creating a warm water, enough for everybody to take a warm shower. So coming this way, cable satellite inlets here, city water connections. This is where I would hook up my hose that is pressurized. Of course, I would want to use a pressure reducing valve, which is something that we give you if you were to purchase this coach from us. Spare tire here, and a Furion backup camera prep. Now that is the prep. We do sell the cameras in our store. We can install that for you. It's good. You constantly have a way of seeing behind you and seeing what's going on. How about we go inside and we take a look in there, huh? Okay, guys, so one of the things they're doing with Wildwood this year is they're gonna go ahead and add these solid steps. Now they're good because they're actually being supported from the ground. And I'm a heavy guy, and if I'm carrying waters, I'm even heavier, right? So these sturdy steps are good for what you need in order for that safer, you know, climb up to the coach without feeling it rocking too much. If you have those good knee, those bad knees, then you know this will help out a lot better. So how about we come on in here, take a look around, tell me what you think. Wildwood likes to do it a little simpler. So they're not doing like the window treatments or anything like that. They're doing the straight pull down shades, white background with the contrasted wood, dark wood, solid surface countertop here. You have also a 50-50 split on the sink, and just a nice room, a nice kitchen. With that slide here, it definitely opens up, allowing you for obviously more sleeping space too. So let's go ahead and get this tour started.
Okay
guys, let's go ahead and start here in the bedroom. We have a queen size bed with access to the storage that's located on the bottom there. They do this little toe kick here for shoes reasons. You know, you don't want them in the little hallway because it is a little restricted, but it's a nice little spot for your shoes. And you also have that storage that I was pointing out on the outside. Here's a little nook for small items or such. You also have some storage on the side, hanging room on both sides, and a little table here and on that side. So if you have those CPAP machines, if you want to put your cell phone down or something like that, it's a good little spot. We're gonna have 2 110 outlets on each side, so that's giving you that more of an option for doing alarm clocks or something like that. These are the pull down shades that are located throughout the coach. They go up and down. That's an exit window there, and they're completely blackout, so that's good. Let's move on this way. Yeah, so if you did notice, you have double entries to the queen size bedroom in the front, which is kind of good. They're pocket doors, but if you're, you know, sleeping with Jill or Jack, you guys have the option of kind of your own little exits, shall I say. This is the main slide that we were looking at on the outside. You have a jackknife couch here, which turns into a single bed, I want to say. One adult can sleep on here comfortably. I mean, I don't need much sleeping space, and I'm not the biggest guy in the world. I'm about 5'7", but I could see about a 6'2" guy maybe sleeping in here. You're camping, right? You're not hotel sleeping in a king size bed somewhere. So these little options that Wildwood gives you is good for that camping experience. Now, if you need more sleeping space, this U-shaped dinette does a great job for that. So the way this works is we have two poles down here that are actually supporting the bed. Once you remove these, there are little pre-made rungs on the side of the table here that hold this part of the table solid, like so. Now I go ahead and pull my cushions, these two here, and now I've created a extra bed here. So this is gonna be longer, and if you need the extra head space or if you need the extra foot space, it's here, guys. Now, this is gonna be a little bit longer. I wanna say about 6 to 7 inches longer than that single there that we just saw. But, I mean, sleeping space in this coach is not something you're gonna need because you have the bunk room over here. Okay, guys, so quad bunk. Here we have a little bit of closet space, I want to say, the cubby holes, a foot and a half or more in space, plenty of room for towels and stuff like that. You're next to the bathroom, and come on in here, guys, check out this bunk room. Like I said, quad bunk, 1, 2, 3, 4, with their own little closet space. This is a hanging wardrobe here, with a little hold rail that they have up there. You're gonna have some drawers here, four of them, and this little bunk here is gonna be something I'm gonna show you guys the size. So like I said, I'm 5'7". You know, I'm reaching with my tippy toes here, and my head is not hitting the end of this. So this is gonna be about, I wanna say 6'2" or so in the space, but it's plenty of room for somebody who's, you know, you cuddle up or you curl up when you're sleeping. You don't you don't long like a board. So it's plenty of space, in my opinion, for somebody who some of those bigger guys, and it's just 1-2 nights or something like that, right? You're not going to be doing an extended amount of sleeping in here. You just want to get through that night and get going to that camping day, right? Okay, guys, so bathroom, right? Because everybody needs a shower. So I am 5'7", like I said, you know, I don't reach the ceiling here. On top of that, we go ahead and add this skylight. So that gives you that extra 2-3 inches of headroom. You know, I got room to shower in here, to lather up, to do what I got to. I got my curtain here. This is a tub style shower, so it's good for the small kiddos. You know, that bunk room is actually perfect if you have a lot of those grandkids and stuff like that. So, mirror medicine cabinet here, with a larger bowl sink, a 110 GFI outlet, space for the toiletries. I mean, you want towels, you want toothbrushes, you want soaps, you want toilet paper, it all fits in here. Last but not least, the Dometic toilet. Comfortable, you know, I got room to do my business, I got room for my knees, no feeling too cramped while you're doing your business. All right, guys, so the kitchen here, we have a 50-50 split on the kitchen sink. We're gonna have some cabinet space up here with the nice hidden hinges. I did say that Wildwood likes to use good quality stuff, good quality wood. They like to accent stuff. That's why you got the glass here. It's just higher quality. Usually your competition will do like a sticker or something. No, Wildwood is doing an actual backboard. You have a 3-burner stove here with a glass top that also acts like a backsplash too. A nice little oven for the cookies and such, for the brownies. You're gonna have a microwave also, so not only do you have that oven, you have a microwave. This is the hood. This is also vented to the outside, so it's good to get all that grease smell out of here, fish smell or whatever it is. Dometic refrigerator, guys. So you have the freezer option on the top and the refrigerator with the 2-liter soda grate option that they give you here. It's ample room. Benefit of it is it runs on gas too. So as long as you have propane, as long as your 12-volt battery is charged, this guy's gonna run. So that's one of the benefits of having a gas electric refrigerator. Okay, guys, so entertainment, right? This is where you would put a TV. It has a backer located on the back of this wood here to give you that extra support. You have a Furion stereo. Now this controls the speakers on the inside and on the outside. It'll do AM, FM, you have USB, you have auxiliary here, you have a headphone jack, everything you need, including Bluetooth. So I can go ahead and hook this up to my phone, do channels, do volume and such. So the other control panel that you have over here or the other option that you have here is the control panel. You're gonna have your battery sensor, you have fresh black and gray tanks just to see what the levels are at, water pump, water heater, you have your cabin lights, you're gonna have the slide, and then you're gonna have the awning button here. One of the other benefits also is I have heated holding tanks, like I said on the outside. The tanks, each tank has a pad on them that when this button is on, it's being heated, it's keeping those tanks from freezing over. Okay, last but not least, Wildwood is famous for making camping easy, making camping simple. I'd keep this in my truck, maybe I'd keep it here when I'm in camping, but the benefits is I can do my lights, I can do my awning, I can do my slide from the outside. Say there's a tree out there, you know, and I'm in here and I can't really see what's going on, this remote will do it. The other benefits are gonna be awning lights. You have also the landing gear, so you know, I can say it's raining or something and I don't want to be out there holding the button, I could do it by remote. Alrighty guys, so what did you think? This was the 282QBXL. Now, quad bunk room with the front queen. This is gonna be one of the units that are on our hail sale. If you'd like to know pricing, contact us via email, sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or you can give us a call, 970-313-4337. If you didn't particularly like this unit, if you wanna see other options, maybe a toy hauler, maybe a fifth wheel, visit our website, www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Thanks a lot, guys. We'll see you in the next video.